Hello students, I hope you all are safe and healthy at home. Today we will discuss new lesson. The name of the lesson is The Last Lesson by Alfonso Daudet. About the author, Alfonso Daudet, 1840-1897, was a French novelist and a short story writer. The Last Lesson is set in the days of Franco-Prussian War, 1870-1871, in which France was defeated by Prussia, led by Bismarck. Prussia then consisted of what now are the nations of Germany, Poland, and parts of Austria. In this story, the French district of Alsace and Lorraine have passed into Prussian's hand. And now, up till this year, we can understand some background, historical background, concerned with the lesson. We will go ahead with the actual lesson. So in this historical background, war background is there. And what is that war background here we can understand? That is Franco-Prussian War. And due to that, here especially two district names are mentioned. And in that, Alsace and Lorraine. And they were in the hands of Prussians, or we can say here Germany, means German language will be imposed on them. So here French language, means here main issue is of the language and the freedom, and whatever the problems here the citizens, those who are from that two districts, how they will suffer because their language, means French language, it would be taken from them. And suppose your mother tongue, if you are speaking in Maharashtra, we are speaking Marathi, and somebody would tell you to don't speak your own language, don't write in your own language, and from next day your Marathi would be banned. So like this, if somebody would tell, will you be agree with that instantly? I don't feel that you will be agree, but suppose if it would be by force or by law or something, due to war situation, somebody would impose that on you, will you be agree with that? Surely there will be resistance. You will never be agree with this, and you will try to think that nothing here it will happen without your mother tongue, because your language, it is not only the script or the symbols, but language, it is the language of your soul. Means because whatever thought process, it will start from your language. And language has a culture, language has tradition, so many things. The legacy language has so many things in that legacy of the language, means from ancient time, so many things it is there, so many literature it is written in that, songs, folk songs, so many things are there. And the dialect of your language, generation by generation, some reforms, new words, additions, and area wise some different dialects also you can observe. So variety of the language, the beauty of your language, everything you can understand, and that it is very important for you to understand your own language. So here, if somebody will tell you that from next day your language would be banned, then what you will do? You will never accept as early as possible, but if it is by force, then you have to accept. And what will be the condition, and that psychological condition somewhat here also the Frenchmen, they are also suffering with that. And here two important characters in this lesson we can observe, and that character here, M. Hamel's character and Franz. So M. Hamel here is a teacher and Franz character is a student. So here I lesson beginning it is with I started for school very late that morning and was great dread of scolding. So here we can observe that everything it is good, but one important thing we can notice here, that beginning of the lesson it is with I. So here I started for school very late that morning and was in great dread of scolding. So here I means here narrator, and this who is narrating the story? The boy Franz is narrating the story. So here this is again important thing we can notice here. I started for school very late that morning and was great dread of scolding, means he was afraid of that. Here Franz, he was afraid of whom? That it is stated, especially because M. Hamel had said that he would question us on participles, and as like English language participles we are studying in the grammar, so same such type of participles it would be there in the French language also. So he was stating that especially because M. Hamel had said that he would question us on participles, and I did not know the first word about them. And here Franz is confessing that he don't know anything about the participles, but and he here M. Hamel, he was very strict teacher and he was going to ask about the participles, grammar topic, and I did not know the first word about them. For a moment I thought of running away and spending the day out of doors. And here he was such type of, means he was not that much sincere student, we can understand. And so he was fond of so many different things. So here it is mentioned, for a moment I thought of running away and spending the day out of doors. It was so warm, so bright. So here in French or there we can understand. Suppose there would be warm day, then that is very good opportunity for them to enjoy. So here due to cold atmosphere, suppose there would be warm weather, then it is better for them to enjoy. So here it is mentioned that it was so warm, so bright, the birds were chirping at the edge of the woods, and in the field back of sawmill the Prussian soldiers were drilling. And here setting it is given that sawmill, and nearby that soldiers, Prussian soldiers were drilling. So here drilling of soldiers, we can hear preparation of soldiers for performance of their duties in peace and war through practice and rehearsal. So here they were doing rehearsal there with proper equipments all, and they were ready for the preparation. Means here soldiers, their daily activity, their drilling they were doing, it was all much more tempting than the rules of participles. And here he was saying it was more tempting, it was attracting me more, that drillings and all the things whatever happening in that area, it was more tempting than the learning of participle. And this year that he was not sincere about the studies, so we can understand that he was focusing on that aspect. Then one more thing we can here notice, but I had the strength to resist, but he he was resisting, no, I will not waste more time, I have to go here, and hurried off to school. When I passed the town hall, there was a crowd in front of the bulletin board. So here, town hall, government building or offices, this type of building, town hall, here we can see. There are so many things here as a narrator he is writing, and in that, for the last 2 years, all our bad news had come from there. The last year, 2 years, means war situation, and due to war situation, whatever, nowadays print media, then electronic media, so many social networking sites, we are getting immediately information. But here in 1871, that time it may not be like this atmosphere, so we can think about that. For last 2 years, all our bad news had come from there, the lost battles, especially about the lost battles, the draft, the order of the commanding officer, and I thought to myself without stopping. So here, what can be the matter now? And one more thing here he is stating, that is bulletin board, and on that bulletin board so many messages, drafts, or especially messages about the lost battles and such type of bad news. And now what happened there? Something new here he is stating, what can be the matter now? And so many people are there, so he was very curious to know about that. Then I hurried by as fast as I could go. The blacksmith, here name is given, Vetcher, who was there with his apprentice reading the bulletin. And here the blacksmith with his apprentice, those who are working under him as a practice beginners, so they were also there. And that blacksmith called the Franz and called for me, don't go so fast, Bob. You will get your school in plenty of times. So here, Bob here he is referring to the Franz, and especially in little bit aggressive mood, and especially the Bob word, it is used for the male, teenage age group like that. But in aggression, that blacksmith he is here speaking such type of statement, that is, don't go so fast, Bob. You will get your school in plenty of times. So school will never go. You wait, you observe what is that, and you can learn. Means here, through this also we can understand that approach towards the school, approach towards education, it was not that much good. And because of that, so many problems. Afterwards also here, through narration, we will get that what were the problems and how villagers, they have not paid proper attention towards the education. Then I thought he was making fun of me and Rich M. Hammond's Little Garden all out of breath. And here one more setting, the narrator is stating, that is M. Hammond's and garden. And where is that garden? Near the school. Usually when school began, there was a great bustle. Means so many students would be outside, noise would be there, and but here, which could heard out of the street. Means when nearby the school, if there would be street, so many children, they will not keep quiet. So too much here bustle he could understand, and easily he can notice that. The opening and the closing of text, lessons repeated in unison, means utterance of the action, repeated action, a chorus action by so many children, students. So that here, lessons repeated in unison, very loud with our hands, over our ears to understand better. And the teacher's great ruler rapping the table. And especially here N. Hamel, and suppose somebody would not listen, then roughing of the ruler we can also hear. So here he was writing that, but now it was all so still, but I am not getting anything. No noise, no bustle, nothing it is there. The atmosphere is cool. Here we can understand very calm and quiet atmosphere here we can observe. But now it was so still, no noise. I had counted on the commotion to get my desk. So here, commotion means a state of confused and noisy disturbance like that here. I had counted on commotion to get my desk without being seen. But of course, that day everything had to be as quiet as Sunday morning. As quiet as Sunday morning means Sunday specially holiday. Because of that, such type of atmosphere we can notice in the school. But that day was working day, it was not holiday. But then also atmosphere was very silent. So through the window, I saw my classmates already in their places. Usually, those who are latecomers, all they may not sit inside. But today, something it is new. All classmates were already in their places, already in their places. And M. Hamel walking up and down with his terrible iron ruler under his arm. And terrible iron ruler means he was very strict. He might be giving punishments to them, so that iron ruler here, terrible, the word he is mentioning, the terrible iron ruler under his arm. I had to open the door and go in before everybody. You can imagine how I blushed here. France is stating one important thing, that you can imagine how I blushed and how frightened I was. And he was too much frightened. Something it is there that all students are inside, and everything here going on very smoothly. Something it has happened. I jumped over the bench and sat down at my desk. Not till then, when I had got a little over my fright. So here fright means sudden intense feeling of the fear. When I got a little over my fright, did I see that our teacher had this beautiful green coat, his frilled shirt and little black silk cap, all embroidered, that he never wore except on inspection or prize days. So here, narrator is stating about the special thing about M. Hamel, that he used to wear such type of dress on only inspection or special occasions. But today there is no special occasion, but then also here Franz was observing the M. Hamel's costume. Besides, the whole school seemed too strange and solemn. And besides, here he was talking about the dress or the costume of the M. Hamel. And he was again stating about the atmosphere is very strange. It is not looking like a school atmosphere. Something here, solemn means formal or dignified, like that something atmosphere he was observing. But thing that surprised me most was to see on the back benches that were always empty. So he was here stating that the back benches was always empty. But the thing that surprised me most was to see on the back benches that were always empty, the village people sitting quietly like ourselves. And he was observing not only the students, but villagers were also there. And they were also sitting very calm and quiet. So what would be the reason that why they are in such way and they are sitting very quietly, something would happen. Old Hauser with his three-cornered hat. And here now he is describing about some villagers in that. One of the character is Old Hauser's character, and especially with his three-cornered hat, the former mayor. And he was telling about again some characters in that former mayor, former postman, and several other beside. So he was telling about Old Hauser, former mayor, former postmaster. Everybody looked sad, and Hauser had brought a wood here primer. Some at ages. So here old primer means old canvas or metal that is very old, that type of thing it was brought by the Old Hauser. And thumb at age means here because of it was soiled, like means it was frequently used. So here it was thumb at ages, here soil ages caused by frequent handling. So here it is mentioned. And he held it open on his knees with his great spectacle laid across the pages. So this is the description, this is the scene. In this scene means school scene, school setting. Franz was surprised to see the atmosphere in the school. Villagers were there, prominently here Old Hauser, former mayor, former postmaster, and several others were also there. And here Old Hauser was with the old primer. And here this atmosphere. Now the very important character, that is M. Hamel. Now M. Hamel will start his lecture. And here what is that here? While I was wondering about it all, M. Hamel mounted his chair and in the same grave, means in same serious tone and grave and gentle tone, which he had used to me, said, "My children, this is the last lesson I shall give you. The order has come from Berlin to teach only German in the schools of Alsace and Lorraine." So here he was stating that one important here thing we can notice here, he is mentioning, "My children, this is the last lesson I shall give." And now what I will do, this would be my last lecture. Further, I would not be able to give the lecture. Reason, what is the reason? The order has come from Berlin to teach only German in the schools of Alsace and Lorraine. The new master comes tomorrow. This is your last French lesson. I want you to be very attentive. And now he is stating that there is an order come from Berlin that you will own, means from next day only, German language here, it will be taught in the schools of Alsace and Lorraine, and French will not be taught. So here this would be the last lesson, and he was requesting that you should be attentive as it is the last lecture. And here suddenly now this type of announcement if teacher will do, then what you will see. As a France, it was not expected to the France. And so here reply we can understand, what a thunderclap these words were to me. And he was totally surprised and shocked to listen this. So we can understand that child psychology, the small child, he was thinking about the language. He was not at all sincere student. But when you will understand that you have to think only about the other language, and that is German language, it is not your own mother tongue, then suddenly the boy like a Franz, he was very surprised, shocked, like it was thunder, it was like a thunderclap. Here he is mentioning, "Oh, the wretches," means unfortunate happening, wretches means unfortunate happening, that was what they had put up at the town hall. And it was that unfortunate happening, and it was there in that bulletin board he was now recalling. So many people, they were there in that phase we can understand. And now new here thing he was thinking, what is that new thing? My last translation? With exclamation he was thinking, my last French lesson? Why? I hardly knew how to write. I don't know that how to write my own language. I should never learn anymore. And if suppose it will not be taught in the schools of Alsace and Lorraine, how I will get that? I must stop there and then. Oh, how sorry I was for not learning my lessons. And he was now feeling regret that I have not learned my lessons carefully when M. Hamel used to teach me. And for seeking birds' eggs, going sliding on the Sar. So here, Sar, a river which passed through the France. That here it is, the word Sar is given. So he was stating that he was more interested on other things, especially in that for seeking birds' eggs or sliding on the Sar. So he was mentioning that. Again, my books that had seemed such a nuisance while ago, so heavy to carry, my grammar and my history of sense were old friends now that I could give up. And M. Hamel too, the idea that he was going away, that I should never see him again, made me forget all about his ruler and how cranky he was. Means whatever the negative thinking about M. Hamel, suddenly now he would not think about that. He was thinking that it is the now last lesson and I will not be able to learn any more French language. So like this year, that was the sudden shock on the small children here. Small children would think like this. And here France was stating about that poor man. And now France is stating about that he was like a poor man. Why poor here? It was in honor of this last lesson that he had put on his fine Sunday clothes. So here, and now I understood why. Here, fine Sunday clothes means Sunday clothes, where we can say, suppose you have nice dress, then you could wore that for special occasions. So like that here he was writing about the Sunday clothes in special costume. So it was in honor to this last lesson. So why all were there? It was in honor to this last lesson that he had put his fine Sunday clothes. And now I understood. And here this boy is stating that now I understand. What is that understanding? Why the old men of the village were sitting there in the back of the room. Only children were there, but today for the lesson, last lesson, villagers also they were there. What would be the reason why they were there? Now he understood that it was because they were sorry too, that they had not gone to school more. So here, some they were illiterate. And he was stating that they are also feeling regret, they are also feeling sorry for that. So that was here we can understand. It was their way of thanking our master for his 40 years faithful service. And here he was stating that it was not the thing. Here we can observe that they were there to give respect. And here, thanking our master for 40 years faithful service. And here, M. Hamel was working in that village for 40 years. And you can understand that if somebody would give commitment in that field, more than here, 10 years, 20 years, 40 years he was there and he was teaching. And because of that, his legacy, his commitment, so many things we can understand. And here, it was their way of thanking our master for his 40 years of faithful service and showing their respect for the country that was there. There's no more. two things were there. One was they were thankful to the M. Hammer, and second thing, there was a respect for the country, means here France, because French language will not be taught in the schools of Alsace and Lorraine from next day. While I was thinking of all this, I heard my name called. It was my turn to recite. What would I not have given to be able to see that dreadful ruler for the participle, although very loud and clear, without one mistake, but I got mixed up on the first word and stood there holding on to my desk, my heart beating and not daring to look up. So here, he was in such a confused state of mind that I don't know anything about the participles, and here the question it will be asked. But next statement, it is important. I heard M. Hamel say to me, "I won't scold you, little France." And here, who is stating that? "I won't scold you now. I will not scold you." What? Here, you must feel bad enough. See how it is. Every day, we have said ourselves, "Bah, I have plenty of time." Every day, we should to say, "Okay, we will learn it tomorrow. We will. We have so many days to learn that." But now, what happened? So here, emotionally, France is here listening properly, and means whenever learning happens, listening is important. And here, M. Hamel is also speaking in such a way that he was also interacting with the children with very proper way, and he was also emotional. "Bah, I have plenty of time. I will learn it tomorrow." And now you see where we have come out. That's a great trouble with Alsace. See, puts off learning till tomorrow. Now, those fellows out there will have the right to say to you, "How is it? You pretend to be Frenchmen and yet can..." Here, you have to pretend like a Frenchman. Why? The reason it is given. "And yet you can neither speak nor write your own language." Now, you will not be allowed to speak your language. You will not be allowed to write your language. So here, but you are not the worst. Poor little France. We have all a great deal to reproach ourselves with. And we have to blame ourselves for some reason. And here, now in the next phase. So in this passage, we are understanding that M. Hamel was speaking with France in such a way that he was stating that. The statement, it is very important. "I have plenty of time. I will learn it tomorrow." Like that, it was the approach of the student. That they were not thinking that we have to learn that thing in particular time, we have to respect teachers, but their approach was different. So here the last statement here is stating that we have all a great deal to reproach ourselves with. Reproach means here a blame. And what kind of thinking here he was stating, next passage it is mentioned. "Your parents were not anxious enough to have you learn." So your parents, they were also not serious about that. What they used to do here, they preferred to put you to work on a farm or at the mills. And they have also preferred that they were, the thinking here we can understand. They used to send you for the work as a child labor, and where? On a farm or at the mills. "So as to have a little more money." And here he was focusing that to have a little more money, he was stating. "And I have been to blame also." And here he was stating that I am also guilty. For what sake here M. Hamel was stating, "And I have been to blame also. Have I not often sent you the what water my flowers instead of learning your lessons. So I have also given you the work. And what is that work? I have also given you the work, and that is to water the plants in that garden. And when I wanted to go fishing, did I not just give you a holiday? And whenever I used to go for the fishing, whenever I wish to go, then I used to give you a holiday. So for that sake, he was blaming himself first. And then here he was setting, means he was blaming the parents, he was blaming students also, because they were also thinking that, okay, we have plenty of time, we will learn it next, or we will learn it tomorrow. So like that, it was their approach. And parents, they were also not serious about the education. And now here we can understand. So here, one important concept and concern with the himself also he was stating, whenever I used to tell you to water the plants in that garden, means such type of task also I used to give. And then here one more thing here we can notice, and that is when I wanted to go fishing, did I not just give you a holiday? And he was stating that whenever I used to give you a holiday, because I wanted to go for fishing. So here this aspect it is important. And then here next approach we can understand. And what is that next approach we will think? Then from one thing to another, M. Hamel went on to talk of the French language, saying that it was most beautiful language in the world, the clearest, the most logical, that we must guard it among us and never forgot it. Because when a people are enslaved, as long as they hold fast their language, it is as if they had the key to their prison. Here, four or five lines, very important lines. Here we will again state that here he was stating about, he was praising the French language. M. Hamel was praising the French language. M. Hamel went on to talk of the French language, saying that it was most beautiful. So here he was mentioning about the French language. French language is most beautiful language in the world, the clearest, the most logical, that we must guard it among us and never forgot it. And we will never forget our own language. Because when people are enslaved, when we are in the prison, or we have such kind of slavery, we are in the slavery, then if we will guard our own language, then what will happen? We will feel united, that we are together. Means we have to work on our own language. So that is what here he was studying. Because when a people are enslaved, as long as they hold fast their language, it is as if they had the key to their prison. And it is the key, means your language, your mother tongue, your French language is the key to come out from that prison. Because when you will be together, when you will think in your own language, when you will have that legacy in your own language, what will happen? You will be together, you will be united, and when you will be together, you can fight, you can approach properly, and your own approach, your unity will give you freedom. Means you will come out from such type of slavery. You will fight against enemies because you will be together. Suppose you are separated, you will not be united. And what is the key? The language is the key, because language is the French language of the mother tongue. It is the soul of your heart. Means our culture, everything depends on that. Folk songs, so many things we can share. We can, means now festivals, so many festivals, or here now Ganesh festival is going on. We can understand that so many different rituals, traditions we are performing, and everything, most of the things we are doing in our own mother tongue. So here we can understand that suppose somebody will ban suddenly our own language, how we will feel. So here M. Hamel in his speech, he is stating that think about this and you will get the way to come out from this prison. Prison means now they are not free. Here Prussians, they have imposed all things on them and they have taken away the right to learn their own language and to speak and write in their own language, mother tongue, especially the French language. And that was the very wrong decision, because if they will not learn their own language, how they will be, how in future they will be patriotic towards their own country. So here everything, it was interlinked. So here we can understand up till this we will think in next video. We will think about the next part of the story. Thank you.